Hello and welcome back to Ganesh Institute channel. So in today's video, what we are going to discuss, I have taken the concept from literary criticism and theory. This is the part of MEG, Masters in English. And we are taking up block one for today, that is classical criticism. And in that too, we are going to study about Aristotle, what he has talked about, this elements of tragedy. Okay, so let's begin. Basically, this is very important concept. What are the six elements of tragedy according to Aristotle? So you can see previous year question papers, you will find out that okay, this is very common question, be it in the form of short note or in the form of long question. Okay, so Aristotle, according to Aristotle, what tragedy means is kind of mimesis. I have already talked about mimesis in some of the videos, so you can check that out. You can check those videos out. So mimesis means imitation, right? Imitation. So what Aristotle says is tragedy is a kind of mimesis. That is imitation of what? Of a particular act which serves a serious purpose. Okay? So tragedy is an imitation of a serious purpose. And how this purpose is served is through direct action. Okay? So rather than using narrative, what we use is direct action in tragedy to achieve the ends, to get the end result. Okay, so basically the aim of tragedy, if we talk about, is to bring about catharsis. So another concept is catharsis. Basically it means to arouse the sensations. Let's say if we are seeing any emotional act and we start crying, so it can be considered as catharsis. So catharsis of the spectators means to arouse in them sensations of pity, of fear, okay, so that they can link with that particular act. Okay, now when we talk about, this is about tragedy, what is it about and what factors it is having. Now, if we talk about six elements of tragedy, these are plot, character, thought, diction, music, and spectacle. Now, what do you mean by plot? So, basically, plot can be considered the main part and soul of the tragedy. Right? So, just think about it. If you are watching a movie, and the setup, the story, that is not up to the mark, then there is no point of watching that story. And it gets less stars also, right? So, a plot in itself must be complete. It should be a whole thing with definite beginning, then middle, then end. Okay? So, we have to know, I mean, when we talk about the tragedy, it should have some length. There should be a particular length of the plot so that spectators can understand it without difficulty. It should not be too long. It should neither be too long nor be too short. Okay? So it should have some separate parts, and in those separate parts, having those separate parts also, with the overall unity. So it should have a central theme in which all the elements should be logically related, so that the fortune of the main character, the protagonist, can be demonstrated. Okay, this plot should emphasize the dramatic causation and the probability of the events. This is about plot, right? When we talk about character, you know, character determines man's qualities, right? Now, with men, I don't mean men and women. I mean a character. So, but it is the action, it is the character's action that makes them happy or wretched, correct? So that's why there is a requirement of imitation of action, life, of happiness, of misery, right? So that we can see that life, it should be look like, okay, it has reality. Okay, so there should be a series of events consisting of action, its end, mode of activity. All this should be comprised in a tragedy. So character means which reveals moral purpose, which show that, okay, what kind of things a character is choosing or avoiding. Then we have thought. When we talk about thought, Aristotle said this is kind of faculty of seeing what is possible and pertinent in given circumstances. So we think according to the situations, right? So if we are having some thoughts of fear, so it is obviously about the situation about which we are thinking, correct? Then we have diction. So what do you mean by diction? You know, when we talk, it is not about only the statement which we just said. It is also about the tone, the words, the meaning, that the expression of that particular word, the meaning behind, hidden behind it, correct? So diction comprises of all these things. What are the word choice, tone, voice clarity, everything comes in it. So tragedy also comprises of diction, okay? Because it is ultimately something, if a situation, a plotting has been made, a character is there, now whether the emotions are reachable, whether catharsis or any that particular sensation can be felt by the audience, it depends on the diction also. How much acting, how much good the acting, if you want to give the star, how much, what is the level of that acting, that is particular thing. Then when we talk about music, so you know that music is also required when we talk about the, you know, embellishments. So it holds the chief place, the main thing to show the emotions. Then we have spectacle. Spectacle means emotional attraction. It is the least artistic part. It is like realistic part, and it has the emotional attraction of its own. All these comprise of six elements of tragedy. I'm hoping that you've got this topic, you've understood it. And if so, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. I would like to request you all to just have a look at this video and try to solve some of the questions. Try to write answers of the questions related with the tragedy, the six elements of tragedy as per Aristotle. Okay. Thank you so much for your time. Take care. Bye.